To the Lord, proclaim His name, make known among the nations what He has done.
Sing to Him, sing praise to Him, tell of all His wonderful acts.
Glory in His holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice.
Look to the Lord and His strength. Seek His face always. Remember the wonders He has done.
Good morning, everyone! How are you today? I hope and pray that all of you are good and safe. Today is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. So come on, everybody. Let's all stand up and join me sing this song. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you.
Let us pray. Dear Father, the giver of life, as we gather this worship, we invite your Holy Spirit to inspire us, guide us, teach us in everything that we do today. Help us to focus our hearts and minds now on what we are about to learn. We ask all this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
The Gospel according to Matthew. He told them another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed, which a man took and planted in his field. Though it is the smallest of all seeds, yet when it grows, it is the largest of garden plants and become a tree, so that the birds come and perch in its branches. He told them still another parable. The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed into about 60 pounds of flour until it worked all through the dough. The kingdom of heaven is like treasure hidden in the field. When a man found it, he hid it again, and then in his joy went and sold all he had and bought that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of the great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it. Once again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was let down into the lake and caught all kinds of fish. When it was full, the fishermen pulled it up on the shore. Then they sat down and collected all good fish in the baskets, but throw the bad away. This is how it will be at the end of the age. The angels will come and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the blazing furnace, which there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all these things? Jesus asked. Yes, they replied. He said to them, therefore, every teacher of the law who has become a disciple in the kingdom of heaven is like the owner of the house who brings out of his storeroom new treasures as well as old. The Gospel of the Lord. Hello kids, a blessed Sunday to you all. The parables of Jesus. The first two parables, the parable of mustard seed and the yeast. Size doesn't matter in the kingdom of heaven. What can we learn about these two parables? Well, I think we can learn that we are never too small to be important in God's eyes. You and I may be small, but we can help to grow in the kingdom of God. Like this mustard seed, it is the smallest seed, but when it grows, it becomes the largest of garden plants. It grows into a tree. Same as this yeast, a tiny amount of yeast, but when it makes up, the yeast has an effect on everything. That is, Jesus wants us to do. He wants us, as part of His kingdom, to change the world around us and make it better. You may be small, literally kids, Small kids, you are important in the kingdom of heaven. Next, parables. Parable of hidden treasure and the pearl. When a man found a treasure in the field, he was happy that he immediately went and sold everything he had and bought the field so that the treasure would be his. Mapapasa kanya. Then another man who went in a search of fine pearls. When he found a pearl was the very best, he sold everything that he had so that he could buy the pearl. Why did two men got that reaction? Pareho silang dalawang reaction. Because they knew it was the greatest treasure of all, like the kingdom of heaven. These parables challenge us what to be prioritized. And Jesus calls us to give up all that we have and follow Him. The last parable, parable of the fishing net. This parable compares the harvest of both good and bad fish to a time at the end of the age when there will be a gathering of all people. The righteous or the good people will be brought to God and the followers of Jesus will cast away. In summary, Jesus wants us to know you are important to Him and He wants us to grow. Second, when we found Him, we should do everything to follow Him. Third, be wise and able to discern what is valuable to Him. Because in the end, we will be judged according to what we have done here on earth. Let us pray. Father, I pray for wisdom, how to train and guide our children. Teach us, O Lord, as your children, to be a good follower of your word. Help us to discern what is pleasing to you and learn from these parables as our guide. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. pray. Thank you, dear Jesus, for your word today. They are so powerful. Teach us, O Lord, to obey it. Teach us to be a good follower of your words. Lord, bless all the children who are worshiping right now with us. Bless their family. Bless their loved ones. Protect them, Lord, and watch over them. We love you so much, Jesus. Amen.